find Ducky using only your sniffer. No getting distracted by green food.
I have hide it. Come and find me.
Now remember, Spike, listen to the sniffer.
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun. Come follow me. Hills to climb and valleys to roam. Oh, streams to follow all the way home. To the land before time.
You were Ducky. You're getting better at sniffing, Spike. At least Mr. Threehorn isn't green food.
Huh. I'm not any kind of food.
Right. And I'd never eat you, even if you were.
Oh, kids.
Don't worry, Spike. You just have to keep trying.
I am still hiding. Yes, yes, yes.
I know you can do it, Spike.
Come and find me, Spike.
Remember, Spike, listen only to the sniffer.
You finded me, Spike. Yup, yup, yup.
Way to go, Spike. Littlefoot?
I believe he's gathering tree stars with Grandpa. This will be Chomper's very first time of great giving.
Oh, how wonderful.
Yeah. So, what's it all about?
Well, many bright circles ago, everyone in the Great Valley learned an important lesson about caring for one another.
And now we celebrate being able to share with each other and not having to worry about sharp teeth.
Yeah, I guess sharp teeth can be a problem sometimes.
Yes, they're horrible, vicious creatures.
I'm gonna go find Littlefoot.
Oh, but I didn't mean him.
Chomper? Oh my.
Huh? Up here, Chomper. We're finding the very best tree stars for the time of Great Giving Feast. Wanna help?
Nah,
Us sharp teeth can't tell the good tree stars from the bad ones.
When I was a hatchling, sharp teeth kept us from eating the tree stars. We had to eat swamp sticks.
Ew.
Finally.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hey, Chomper, come on. You don't want to miss the feast, do you?
I guess not. Nothing but green food.
Chomper, sit with me.
Come along, children. It's not safe to play with sharp teeth.
Maybe I should go back to the mysterious beyond, Ducky. Nobody wants me here.
Oh, no, no, no! The mysterious beyond is not safe, Chomper. It is full of bad sharp teeth, like Red Claw.
Yeah, I know, but I'm a sharp tooth.
Yes, but you are a nice sharp tooth. And you are our friend. You even teach us things you know. Like today, you teach Spike how to use his sniffer to find me.
Yeah, I guess.
You are a very good teacher, Chomper. You are, you are.
Say, if I can teach Spike how to use a sniffer, maybe I can teach Sharp Teeth how to be nice.
Oh, I do not think...
Thanks for the great idea, Ducky. You're really smart.
I am? Oh, thank you, Spike.
Once I teach Sharp Teeth how to be friends, the mysterious beyond will be as nice as the Great Valley.
Chomper? I've looked everywhere I can see, and I can't see him anywhere.
He left the Great Giving early. He said something about teaching Sharp Teeth how to be friends.
Sharp Teeth? Friends? Me no like sound of that.
Me neither. We better find him fast.
How are we gonna do that?
We can sniff for him. Spike finded me with his sniffer, so he can find Chomper too.
I don't think Spike's able to sniff out anything he can't eat.
Oh, but he can! Chomper taught him how.
You can sniff him, Spike, I know. Your sniffer knows the way to go. Do it like you did before. And we will find him for sure. Go sniff him out. I do not have a doubt. You can sniff Chomper out. Your sniffer is very smart, so let us start.
Here's where Chomper stood today.
Okay, Spike, now sniff away.
Look at that, he's got the scent.
Show us where he went. Go sniff him out.
You can sniff him out.
Do not have a doubt.
There can be no doubt.
You can sniff Chomper out.
Sniff and sniff him out.
You can show us how to find Chomper now. Go sniff him out.
I would have seen some sharp teeth by now. Oh, well. I'll find some sharp teeth to teach tomorrow. After a good night's sleep. I didn't know anyone lived here, but maybe we can be friends? Right! You speak Sharptooth! Chomper went, Spike?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's go. A sharp tooth! Hey! Over here! Wanna be friends? Earthshake! Wow! Lots of sharp teeth! Hey, watch the hurry! We can't be friends if you run away! Oh no! Redclaw! I'll probably never be able to teach Redclaw to be friendly. Spike? Did you find anything?
He found something, all right. Breakfast.
No, look! Spike finded footprints.
Chomper!
Hey, somebody my own age. This should be better. Hi there. Wanna be friends? If we're friends, we can play catch. I'll throw and you catch. Oops, that's okay. You're just learning. Easy there. We bite our food, not our friends. Ouch! Hey!
made this harder than I thought.
Funny. There sure are a lot of footprints, but we haven't seen any shark teeth yet.
Oh, that not funny. That great.
Yeah, I'm sure Chomper's okay. So much for making friends. White Mountain. Those shark teeth won't chase me up there. I know I wouldn't. It's cold. Oh no!
Sounded just like Chomper.
Yeah, come on. Maybe trying to teach Sharp Teeth in the Mysterious Beyond wasn't such a good idea. Littlefoot! Hello!
Hello!
Chomper! Where are you?
I'm, down here! I mean, I don't know where I am!
Spike, is that you? Spike, you can find me! Remember, just let your sniffer be your eyes and ears! You're here! How are we gonna get down there?
Spike, this is no time to eat! We're trying to figure out... Spike?
Spike. Let's get out of here.
Chomper!
We were very worried about you, Chomper. We were.
We looked everywhere we could see for you, but we couldn't see you.
So we had to smell for you instead.
You were right, Ducky. You are my friends, and those sharp teeth don't care about me at all. And I can't teach them anything. I've heard that sound before. We gotta get out of here.
Ground, move!
What do we do now?
Well, we can't stay here, that's for sure. Everybody jump!
I've had enough of this hard water to last me a lifetime.
Well, at least we're all alive to enjoy our lifetimes.
We better keep moving.
Unless Chomper here can teach Redclawna's pal some manners.
Oh, no. I don't think I'm ready to teach Sharpteeth how to get along.
Or maybe they're not ready to be taught.
Either way, I think we should head home. You left the time of great giving before we could give you your feast, Chomper.
We found your favorite things because that's what you like.
Wow! Thanks, everyone!
If we don't explore anything.
But we are exploring the caves.
Well, I'm bored with the caves. See? This is better.
Yes.
Oh, the bright circle is much brighterer out here.
Well, we have been in the caves longer than we have been out of them.
Hey, wait for me!
Do you want some help?
Perhaps some help would help you.
It's not too high.
There you go. I've never been here before.
That's the point of having an adventure. Hey, this place reminds me of some place.
Maybe you've been here before.
Maybe. But everywhere I've been in the Great Valley, you've been too.
It does not look familiar to me. No, no, no.
Redclaw! Now I remember this place. It's... the mysterious beyond! Run!
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun. Come follow me.
Hills to climb and valleys to roam. Oh, streams to follow our way home. To the land before time.
Under these trees.
Great idea, Hatchling!
Ah!
Petrie!
Good idea, Petrie! Let's go!
How is that a good idea?
It looks very scary.
And narrow!
Exactly! It's too narrow for Red Claw!
Chopper! Quit slowing us down!
Woo! That was close. We're safe. For now.
I think now might end sooner than we think.
Here.
But Thud and Screech are really good sniffers. We'll be okay as long as we stick together.
Right, together.
So they can eat us together?
From his claws.
And his teeth.
There is not very much room for us and Thud. And Thud's teeth. Oh, I do not like being this close to a sharp tooth. Oh, well, this close to a mean one, I mean.
I thought we just came this way.
That dumb old Earthshake changed everything. That Earthshake also helped us escape Thud. You have to take the good with the bad, otherwise, you won't get to take anything.
Hmm.
Now what did he say?
He doesn't believe we're friends.
Oh.
Look, we're back where we started. Great, we're running in circles.
That good. But Chomper and Ducky know here. We no go back.
Not without our friends.
Mm-hmm. But they on high and rocky ledge. Me no know how to help them.
Neither do I. But we'll find a way.
That ridge that leads back towards them might help us reach them.
Then let's go.
Not, but I wish I could help him.
If we do, he'll just eat us sooner. He's a sharp tooth. That's what they do.
You are also a sharp tooth, and that is not what you do. Oh, he sounds more hurted.
Well, he does have rocks on his tail.
Just hold on tight, it will be all right.
What if we are stuck here all night? That nasty Thud gave me a fright, and he is much too big to fight.
Ducky, don't be afraid. I'm sure our friends are on the way. Stay close to me, and you will see.
be okay.
Using the trees, I had an idea.
That's a good reason to get eaten.
We can use trees to rescue Chomper and Ducky.
Still not a very good reason to get eaten.
I hope they get here soon. Is he calling you little again?
Yeah, and he doesn't believe our friends will rescue us.
But they are our friends. Is that not what friends do?
I guess not in the mysterious beyond.
That's why Petrie no like adventures. Wish me not go adventuring. Let me not go adventuring, me not be here right now.
Petrie, please, you must be brave while we still have our friends to save.
You know they do.
You cannot reach us and then eat us. No, no, no.
He said I'm too little. And he's right. If he gets loose, I'm too little to protect us. Or help us get out of here. I'm too little to do anything.
You are sad about being little, but that is only on the outside. Today, you've been big enough on the inside to make me feel safe. You have, you have.
Hey! Are you all right? I am now.
Oh, behind you, Missy Thud! Thud!
Don't worry, Thud won't hurt us.
Maybe it's a different Thud?
He cannot get to us. He is stuck.
Me stay away, just in case.
And we will rescue you. Also just in case.
That one, Spike!
That Thud who is big. Our friends may be littler than Redclaw, but they always help us because they are big inside.
Together when we are someplace else together, like home.
Oh, hey!
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun.
Come follow me. Hills to climb and valleys to roam. Oh, streams to follow on our way home. To the land before time.
Hi.
Guido!
What were you doing in there?
I was just hiding, you know, until the wind settled down.
Hi, Guido. Remember me and Ruby? We met you the last time you babysat Trisha.
Chomper, the friendly sharp tooth. How could I forget? You're still friendly, right?
Yep. You still learning to fly?
Oh, that. Well, being a glider, it is kind of hard to get off the ground without a little help.
Maybe big blowy wind give you lots of help. See, like...
But it's really blowy.
It'll be okay, Guido. Petrie will help you.
Me will. Oh, yes, me will. Well... I really would like to fly. Oh, I should have stayed in my stump.
You can do it, you good glider.
Well, that's really nice of you to say, but... And whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa. Wings, Guido! Wings!
What? Oh, right! Wings! Whoa, whoa,
whoa. Woo! Blowy make you fly good.
Yeah, it does kinda, doesn't it?
Now, follow me.
Follow, he says.
It getting too blowy. We done now.
Oh, yeah, but I want to... Hey, wait! Whoa, 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 whoa! Did you see me out there? Oh, come on, Petrie, let's do it again. I've got a twisty turn one more time. Oh, come on, Petrie, please, 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 please.
No, too blowy now. We fly tomorrow.
Tomorrow? But my wings are all warmed up now.
No, not safe.
I thought blowy was good. You see? It's okay! First, I swoop! Oh, boy. Oh, boy! Whoa! Whoa!
What is he doing? Why is he going up so high?
Hey, wind! Stop! Whoa! Help!
No. Need better help.
Grown-ups.
engine stopped.
Winghurt. Oh, what place this?
I think we're inside Black Rock.
Black Rock? That not good.
I know. Mind helping me up? Okay. Ow, 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 ow. Ooh. Ooh, I must have landed funny on my foot.
Yes, I... Oh, ow, oh, ow, ow. And Mino can fly.
Yeah, but at least you can walk. See if you can find a way out of here, all right?
Okay. Oh, too steep. No climb here.
Petrie! Over there!
May not see anything. It's too dark.
And I'm afraid of the dark. I'm afraid of caves, but most of all, I'm afraid of being afraid.
Guido, you're more scared than me.
Scared. Don't be scared. It's easier to say than do,
but singing helped me know it true.
Then I will try to sing with you
and not be scared.
Oh, it's awfully dark way down here in the Black Rock.
It's very Black Rock.
Maybe it's not so bad if we find an easy way out.
Hey, let's just find any way out, okay?
Don't be scared. Don't be scared.
Pretend that you'll be brave and strong. You know the tune, so sing along.
Hope I don't end up being wrong.
Not being scared.
Petrie, I gotta admit, I'm not as scared as I was. Now I'm more scared!
It's all this stupid wind's fault.
I just hope they find Petrie and Guido soon.
Oh, I can't look. What's there? Tell me. If it's too scary, don't tell me. Star plant. Well, at least you won't starve.
Oh, crawlers! You eat too. You feel better.
Yeah, not bad for cave crawlies. Petrie,
you hungry?
Oh, sorry, fellas. My manners ain't what they used to be. I don't get many visitors around here. The name is Swooper. Now, I've lived here for a long, long time, but it ain't so bad. You see, I'm not alone. This here is Cliff, and the tall one over yonder goes by Slim, and then the good looker in the corner, why, that's Aggie.
He has been here a long time.
Why you stay so long?
Why? Well, because I'm blind.
Oh no! I didn't find them!
Petrie's mom looks so tired.
We can't just sit here. We gotta do something to help. I hate feeling so helpless.
Say, maybe we can't help Petrie and Guido, but we can help the helpers.
Swooper? You blind? How you get around?
Ooh, that's simple. I memorized every last bit of this place. Between hearing and smelling, why, I can figure out exactly where you fellas get to. That's also how I could tell you were eating my ground stars.
Back home in Great Valley, there's so much food. Everybody friends, everybody happy.
The Great Valley, hmm? Why, that sounds like the kind of home I've always dreamed about. Of course, I could never get there. That trip's too risky for a blind old flyer like me.
Oh, me wish we'd take you there. Oh, but me still no can fly. Guido still hurtin', you no see. Oh, we never get back to Great Valley.
Yep. If we tried to walk there, a sharp tooth would get us for sure.
You know, there might be a way. What if you fly while Petrie and I ride on your back? We could be your eyes.
Ooh, I don't know. It sounds risky, mighty risky. I'd have to think long and hard before I'd give that a try. Well, I've made up my mind. I'm sure gonna miss you two. I'm heading for the Great Valley with my new friends. If you're ever out that way, I'll stop by and visit, you hear?
Fresh air, if you ask me.
Home that way.
Well, let's get it going. Hop on.
Swooper, when exactly was the last time you flew?
Oh, let me see now. It was so long ago.
Okay, maybe on second thought.
Here we go! Takes me a bit to get used to flying again, you know. Now, which way?
Point your beak a little left.
Oh,
wait! Hey, Yeah, okay, that's good. That's the fastest way to the valley.
No! No, no, no! No, still too blowy. Fly around. Go right! Left! Right! Left! Right! Left! Right!
Oh, Phyllis, if we're gonna get anywhere, we gotta work together.
Okay, Swooper's right. You've flown more, Petrie. You decide which way.
Guido helped too. Use your wings. Feel for change in wind.
I can do that.
Oh, that's better. Especially since I can only go in one direction.
You some tree stars.
We gathered enough for all the flyers. We wanted to help.
Thank you all very much. I haven't had much time for food since...
Oh, do not be sad. Petrie will come home. He will. He will.
I know, little one. They'll both be home. Just as soon as the wind stops and we can go find them. I just hope they're safe.
Whew. I haven't flown this long in ages. What say we land so I can take a load off? We got a problem. I'm not sure how long I can keep going.
Well, then Petrie fly. Make easy for Swooper. Oh, oh, oh.
You're not ready to fly, Petrie. I guess I'll have to glide for a while.
You sure?
Well, one of us has to get off Swooper's back, and this trip was my idea.
You can do it, you good glider.
You're right. I can do this. Hey, this isn't so bad. I'm gonna check things out up higher. Hey, Swooper, Petrie, come on up here. The wind's blowing toward the Great Valley. You can rest your wings.
Oh, it does these old bones good to soar again. We'll be getting to your valley in no time.
Oh, me hope so.
It's true. They've been spotted. They've come back to us.
Woo-hoo! We did it, Swooper! We're home!
And we never would have made it without you, Guido.
You're hurt.
A little. Maybe okay. This Swooper, he flew me home.
Thank you so much, Swooper.
Glad to do it, ma'am. But the whole idea was Guido's, and he found the wind that helped us get here.
We never make it home without wind.
Oh, thank you, Guido.
Thank you.
Oh. Everyone, let's give Petrie, Guido, and their new, I mean, our new friend, Swooper, a big welcome home.
It's good to be home, all thanks to our new friend. We finally safe now. Our journey is at an end.
Take it, Petrie.
Okay. It blowy day.
Things look pretty hopeless. We thought we might
never get home. Then we met you.
And when we worked together,
we used the wind
to make our way back here.
It's good to be home, all thanks to our new friend. We're finally safe now. Our journey is at an end. Swooper's a hero, so let's all sing and cheer.
I like the sound of that.